If you're used to composing and recording using your computer and digital audio workstation, or DAW, you're likely to know how workflow can affect your creativity and how repetitive yet mandatory tasks can hinder your concentration. As a tool at the service of music makers, we endowed KeyLab MkII with the MCU HUI protocol so that it adapts to any creative environment and streamlines your composition and recording sessions. In this episode, you will learn how your KeyLab MkII allows you to browse your tracks, set their panning and volume, and access useful features from your DAW without having to use your mouse. The integration between your KeyLab MkII and Ableton Live is particularly advanced. Its strength is to offer a deep integration with virtually any DAW, thanks to the MCU HUI protocol. This tutorial will mainly focus on elements that apply to all of them and add specific details about Ableton Live. The KeyLab MkII is a class-compliant device that doesn't require specific drivers, so all you have to do is plug it in and select it in the MIDI preference of your DAW. Please check the user manual of your DAW for details. With a simple click of the DAW mode button, you get dedicated control over its most useful features. The KeyLab MkII offers several configurations depending on the DAW you will be using. Select the DAW mapping by holding the DAW button for a couple of seconds and browsing with the big knob. Press the big knob to select your DAW. Your KeyLab MkII is provided with a set of magnetic overlays to make sure that the labels of the DAW section reflect its exact functionality. Depending on the knob mode selected, the main knob, the DAW control section, and the control section on the top right part of the panel will serve different functions. Only in Ableton Live, the pads are assigned to a specific function. During the creative process, it is crucial to have intuitive control at your fingertips. Let's take a look at how the mapping works with one of the DAWs. It will be very similar to any of the other DAWs from the list. In the DAW mode, the main knob and transport section lets you accurately navigate and control your project without having to use your mouse. You will be able to control rewind, fast forward, stop, play, pause, record, and loop mode. The arrow buttons by the main knob let you browse your track. In Ableton Live, the role of the main knob will depend on the view mode you are in. If you are in arrangement view, the main knob will let you move the time bar like in the other DAWs. In session view, the main knob will let you browse the clips within the selected track. The top right part of your KeyLab MkII lets you browse the tracks within your DAW and control their main parameters. The knobs control the panning while the faders control the volume of 8 of your tracks. In addition to the arrows next to the main knob, you can select a track using the bottom row of buttons. If your project is made up of more than 8 tracks, use the 3 buttons on the left to shift the set of tracks that knobs and faders control. Toggling on the bank button will let you move your track by group of 8 using the next and previous buttons instead of one by one. The ninth fader always controls the master volume of your project. The first row of buttons in the DAW command section contains your track controls. The first 2 buttons will let you solo or mute the track you selected. The third button will let you set the selected track as ready to record. The fourth and fifth buttons are related to automations. In most cases, the read button lets you activate and deactivate the automations, while the write button is used to activate the recording of new automations. For Ableton Live, the fourth button, arm, is used to activate the recording of an automation. If a parameter has a recorded automation and we modify it manually, it will deactivate the automation. To reactivate the automation, use the fifth button, re-enable. The second row of buttons of the DAW command section includes the global controls. These ones affect your whole project. The first button is used to save your project, except in Ableton Live. This button is dedicated to switching between the session and arrangement view. In most cases, the second and third buttons allow to determine the punch-in and punch-out points. Punch-in recording consists of your DAW switching automatically between playback and recording so that you can only record a specific section in your project. Used in coordination with the main knob, it will significantly accelerate your recording sessions. For Logic Pro 10, the second button allows to switch between the replace and overdubbing recording modes, and the third button engages the auto punch function. The fourth button toggles on and off the metronome of your DAW. At last, regardless of the DAW you consider, the fifth button is always dedicated to the undo functionality. The integration with Ableton Live provides functional benefits. The KeyLab MK2 pads complement the DAW commands to speed your workflow. The launching of recording, playing, and combining your clips has never been so intuitive. The pads let you control the clips of 8 tracks of your project. Just like the knobs, faders, and buttons, the range of tracks you control can be shifted using the next and previous buttons. The first 4 tracks of the current range are distributed horizontally across the top 2 rows of the pads. The following 4 tracks of the current range are distributed horizontally across the last 2 rows of the pads. Therefore, for each track, 2 clips are represented by the pads. The top pad represents the clip on the line that is currently highlighted by the cursor of your DAW. The bottom pad represents the clip that is just below. Remember, the main knob lets you scroll up and down the clips of your project, which combined with the pads give you instant access to all the clips of the current range of tracks. The pads present the state of your clips in a simple color code for maximum readability. A switched off pad means the related clip slot is empty, which is likely to be the case for a new project. In order to start recording a specific clip, select the related track using the arrows or the select buttons. Push the record button. Pushing one of the 2 pads of the track will launch its recording. At this moment, the pad turns red when the related clip is being recorded. To stop recording, push the same pad, which will immediately play this clip on a loop, or press the stop button. At this moment, the pad will turn green to represent that the related clip is being played or ready to play. There can be only 1 green clip at a time for a given track. This process can be repeated for any other empty slot. If several clips are present in the same track, the pads related to the clips that are not ready to play will be yellow. The KeyLab MK2 allows you to communicate so efficiently with your DAWs that you're free to focus on what really matters: creating music. See you in the next episode.